Leviticus chapter 20 verse 9, listen carefully. For everyone that curses his father or his mother shall be surely be put to death. He has cursed his father or his mother, his blood shall be upon him. In Exodus chapter 20 verse 2 to 6, time will not permit us to read all the Bible verses. Let's concentrate on 2 to 4. The Bible says, I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt and out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. For thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image, or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Close your eyes. Shout this prayer point loud and clear. Say, satanic altars of generational curses still in operation in my lineage. Satanic altars of generational curses still in operation in my lineage. Be broken in the name of Jesus. Be broken in the name of Jesus. Be broken in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You're welcome to Evangelist Joshua TV, a TV station that will teach you how to interpret your dreams. Today, we are going into warfare prayers. What is our prayer topic today? Our prayer topic is prayer to break family curses. Prayer to break family curses. The reason why so many families are not progressing is as a result of the curse. The reason why many people are finding it very difficult to marry is as a result of some certain causes that is operating or still in operation in that family. Obviously, the opposite of blessing is a curse. There's a strong force that goes with curses whenever it is being issued. Breaking a family curse is a big problem for many people, despite their deliverance prayers and fasting. In Exodus chapter 20 verse 2, the Bible makes us to understand that prayer is one of the ways to break and bring you and your family out of generational curses and covenant. So many families have called upon pastor for family liberation. So many families have called so many pastors to break generational curses. It seems the problems are spreading faster and affecting more innocent souls. Before breaking any family curses emanated from your lineage, it is very, very wise and very, very important as a child of God for you to destroy or set ablaze anything that looks like an idol, anything like that looks like an altar, anything that looks like an ancient trees in your family. Almost every family in Africa, listen to this, almost every family in Africa have a peculiar problems that troubles them. It could be an arrow of generational poverty. It could be an arrow of generational debt. It could be an arrow of generational sickness, ancestral debt, and so on and so forth. A family with ancestral curse will continue to experience various degrees of challenges. God can curse a family. Satan can curse a family. A man can lay a long effect of curses upon somebody. You could just have people in your life, especially the firstborn in your family. They are always jobless or roaming about the street. To remove generational inherited curses as always be through repentance, confession unto prayers. For example, when Israel turned from idols to serve God, the curse was broken and God saved them, as taken from the book of Judges chapter 3 verse 9. There could be someone in the family, there could be a strong man in your family who does not want the ancestral spirit behind the problems to go away. There are some powers in the polygamous who does not want a particular family to progress. There are some man or woman who are within the confines of your family. They do not want you. They do not want a particular set of family to live a fulfilled life while they are left behind. That is polygamous witchcraft. As my father in the Lord, Dr. Dike Olukoya, always said, I pray may the Lord give you that spirit of understanding and grace in Jesus' name. So today we are praying prayer to break family curses. By the grace of God, we have section 1, we have section 2, we have section 3. All these three sessions as a confession prayers and a praise and worship for 10 minutes for each session. Section 1, I want you to close your eyes. Begin to ask God for mercy. God, have mercy upon me. In any way I've sinned against you, have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon me. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The section 1, the confession is taken from the book of Ezekiel, chapter 37, verse 23. The confession is taken from the book of Ezekiel, chapter 37, verse 23. Then praise and worship to be taken for 10 minutes. 10 minutes. Close your eyes. Shout this prayer point loud and clear. Say, let the blood of Jesus and the fire of God purge out my foundational curses. Purge out my foundational curses. Let the blood of Jesus and the fire of God purge out my foundational curses. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number 2. Shout this prayer point, please. Without any distraction. Say, I take full authority over every inherited family curses, and I command them to be broken. Be broken. Every inherited family curses upon my life, be broken. Be broken. I say be broken. Be broken. In the name of Jesus, I take authority over inherited family curses operating in my life, and I command it to be broken. Be broken. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number 3. Say, I renounce, I break all generational curses put on my family line and my descendants. In the name of Jesus, I renounce and break all generational curses put on my family line and my descendants. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number 4. I want you to shout this prayer point loud and clear. Say, I command every bad spirit behind any curses tormenting my family to release and let us go. In the name of Jesus, I command every bad spirit behind any curses tormenting my family to release and let us go. Let us go. Let us go. Let us go. By fire. Go, 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 go. You generational curses tormenting my family. Go, go. Your time is up. Go, go. Your time is up. Go. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number 5. I want you to shout this like a wounded lion. Say, every foundational curse upon my life and family, break away from my life. 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 You, that brother, you are not praying. You, not that sister, you are not praying. You have been laboring for so long, no achievement. Begin to pray. Foundational curse, be broken. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number 6. Shout this last prayer point for this session loud and clear. Say, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, redeem my soul, redeem my body, redeem my spirit from every ancestral curse and ungodly dedication. In the name of Jesus, blood of Jesus, redeem my soul, my body, my spirit from every ancestral curse and ungodly dedication. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. If you are taking that prayers in section 1, I pray the Lord will break every inherited generational curses, stubborn curses that is affecting your life, affecting your progress, the curses that does not want you to achieve anything, the curses that does not want you to reach the height of your destiny, the curses that does not want you to gather things in life. Any kind of curses shall be broken away from your life. In Jesus' name. By the grace of God, we are going to session 2. In this session 2, our confession Bible verse is taken from the book of Colossians, chapter 1, verse 13 to 14. I want you to open your Bible and read that Bible verse and turn it to machine gun prayers. Then praise and worship. Take praise and worship for good 10 minutes before you embark on this prayer. Close your eyes. Shout prayer point number 1 louder and clear. Shout it loud and clear. Say, my family glory, my family glory, My family glory, hear the word of the Lord. Wherever you are hidden, arise by fire, arise by fire, arise by fire. My family glory, wherever you are hidden, arise by fire, arise by fire. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number two. I want you to lay your two hands upon your head and shout this prayer point loud and clear. Say, my Father, arise and destroy every work of witchcraft ever done against our life in the name of Jesus. Say, my Father, arise and destroy every work of witchcraft ever done against my family in the name of Jesus. Destroy by fire, destroy by fire, destroy by fire, destroy by fire. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number three. You are going to practicalize this prayer point. You are going to practicalize this prayer point. You are going to mention your surname, because our surname is attached to our foundation. You are going to mention the street, where the street of your village. You are going to mention the evil pattern of your family, and tell it to God. Mention your surname, mention the street of your village, mention the evil pattern of your family, and begin to make that request to God. That is prayer point number three. Begin to mention it right now. Begin to mention those names, surnames, the streets of your village. Begin to mention them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number four. Say, let every ungodly association and agreement between my family and other families be scattered in the name of Jesus. Let every ungodly association and evil agreement between my family and other polygamous families, witchcraft family, be scattered in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number five. I want you to shout this prayer point. Shout this prayer point. Write your name at the piece of paper. On the piece of paper, write your name. Maybe the name of your children, the name of your father, your name of your husband or your wife. Write them at the piece of paper. And say this prayer point loud and clear. Place your hand on that paper. Say, every curse, every evil covenant, and all inherited problems passed down to all firstborn, passed down to all first son, passed down to all first daughter of my family, be cancelled, be cancelled, be cancelled, be cancelled, be cancelled. Every curse and evil covenant and all inherited problems passed down to all firstborn, first son, first daughter of my family, be cancelled, be cancelled, be cancelled. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number six, which is the last prayer in session two. I want you to shout this prayer point loud and clear. Say, every power that is putting a total stop to celebration and good news in my life, every power that is putting a total stop to celebration and good news in my life, die, 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 die. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. If you are taking that prayer point in session two, congratulations. Every stubborn Goliath, every power, demonic spirit behind any polygamous witchcraft, you are in a family where they are rebelling against each other, today the Lord will release you from the grip of every foundational witchcraft bondage in the name of Jesus. Quickly, we are going to session three. Our confession Bible verse is taken from the book of Matthew chapter 18 verse 18 to 19. Then the praise, you're going to take praise and worship for good 10 minutes. Praise and worship for good 10 minutes. Close your eyes. Begin to ask God for mercy. Say, God, have mercy upon me. Prayer point number one. I want you to shout this prayer. If you want total deliverance from family curse, I want you to take this last session loud and clear. Say, every Balaam hired to curse my family and lock us up in foundational bondage. Say, every Balaam hired to curse my family and lock us up in foundational bondage, release us and die, release us and die, release us and die, release us and die. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number two. Say, every curse of thou shall not excel, every curse of thou shall not prosper, operating in my lineage, operating in my family, break and release us, break and release us, break and release us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number three. Say, let the blood of Jesus neutralize the effect of generational curses upon our life in the name of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus neutralize the effect of generational curses upon our life in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number four. Say, I renounce every demonic name attached to me and my family in the name of Jesus. I renounce them by the blood of Jesus. Every demonic name attached to my life and my family in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. In prayer point number five. Prayer point number five. I want you to shout this prayer point. Shout this prayer point. I want you to bring out water. Bring out water. Read Psalm 35 in that water. After reading Psalm 35 on that water, then take this prayer. Listen carefully. Bring out that water. Bring out your water. Read Psalm 35 into that water. And take this prayer point into that water. And after that, you use that water to bath, to remove every curse operating in your life. It's a practical prayer point. Say, oh God, arise. Remove the generational sin, the generational curses that is preventing my divine intervention in the name of Jesus. Remove them by fire. Remove them by fire. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number six. Begin to thank God for the deliverance of your family from the curse of limitation, barrenness, marital problem, joblessness, and poverty in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Amen. So if you have taken those prayers, congratulations. The Lord will deliver you from every generational curses and family evil inheritance in the name of Jesus Christ. And you are watching this broadcast and you have not given your life to Christ, there's no way the prayer against generational curses will work. You need to surrender your life to God in prayers. You need to repent every known sin. You need to keep resisting the advances of the wicked against you. You need to plead the blood of Jesus Christ upon your life and the life of your family. And if the curses are still coming, you feel that you are still under curses, you need to go for deliverance at Mountain of Fire and Miracle Ministry. And the Lord will do a new thing in your life in Jesus' name. So if you want to subscribe to this channel, can you use this opportunity to subscribe? Subscribe to this channel and God will continue to bless you. Once again, this is Evangelist Joshua from Lagos.